In 1998, October, when Hurricane Mitch came through and just destroyed the country, the head of the Salvation Army in Cleveland, Colonel Norman Voisey, was a friend of ours and had kind of grown up with my older brothers. And they knew that four of us at the time were physicians and said, you know, we'd like to send you to Honduras just to see what you could do, you know, if you could just help a little bit. So we went on down there with the medicine that we could accumulate in such a short time. We took a lot of antibiotics and analgesics and Tylenol, etc.
Everything was brown. When you looked down flying in, everything was brown. All the green had been washed away or blown away.
I remember him saying to me, how do I get rid of the noise in my head? He said, the cries of the people being carried out to sea from the floodwaters.
And when you get down there, you realize, you know, okay, we got all these supplies and everything, but the most important thing is we are here to just help people.
When you go there, you see a different face of humanity.
It's very clear that they need our help and that they don't have access to good medical care there.
There would be 200, 250 people waiting when we would arrive at about 8, 8:30 in the morning.
People would come from miles and miles.
What really brings us to work every day is helping people. And when we go to Honduras, it's clear and it's evident that's what we're there for.
When you're all in of one mind and in one accord, so to speak, it becomes a very powerful tool that impacts people.
So I think it's not only physical, medical, you know, there's a huge spiritual component to it also.
Each one of them, each one of the doctors and nurse took the time to see not the patient, to see the person. And for me, I think that was a great opportunity to go there and help people and be able to be like that bridge between the people of Honduras and the doctors.
The Army is living out its mission of heart to God, hand to man, you know, and get your boots dirty on the ground where you are, no matter where that is.
What kept me coming back on the trip was the success of the trips, the good that we did. I think a lot of patients' lives were changed because of our trips.
Moving forward, I remember my dad talking about working with the Army Corps of Engineers, building bridges, planting trees, and you know, having volunteers locally to participate in all of that.
So it became exciting to learn that the country was evolving and trying to take care of the people that live there.
You know, truly amazing that Dr. Raymond was able to start this and continue it for two decades. Just the energy and the devotion that he had towards this effort is amazing.
We're trained to treat diseases and help folks, but we can't do that without the undergirding of an organization like the Salvation Army.
I just could not believe the reach the Salvation Army gave us on these trips and the impact that it had.
We are definitely an international movement.
The Cleveland Clinic allowed me to bring up two children per year. The most recent patient we brought up was a 20-year-old gentleman, Daniel. He would develop tremendous and long-lasting palpitations that would really take him to his knees sometimes.
Sometimes, you know, you feel like everything is lost and there's always someone or something that is like a second chance, like an angel for you. So do not give up. My goal is to exercise. You know, I haven't been able to exercise like in my whole life. I just have thankful words. I really appreciate all the help that they have given me. Everybody knows someone that needs another person to help us.
The good Lord gave us all talents, and maybe your talent is time, and maybe your talent is prayer. Maybe it's cooking, or maybe you've got money. Whatever your talent is, you need to use that.
In the Salvation Army, you've got to really be dedicated and love the Lord and use that love to help others.